What's up, guys? DRJ here. Today I'm going to talk to you guys again about post-launch thoughts of Diablo 3. So, just to do a little bit of a recap, you guys know that I played the shit on Diablo 1, played the shit on Diablo 2, played D3 beta, and then obviously now playing the full game. I've also have softcore, hardcore characters, melee, ranged. I feel like I have a pretty decent base to be talking about this stuff. I'm definitely not a world first fucking inferno run or anything like that, but I still feel like I'm up there. So hopefully what I say has some legitimacy to it. Let's see, there's quite a few things to talk about. What do I want to go on first? I think the first thing I want to say, which kind of, I don't know, just jump into it, is melee versus range. So melee versus range, basically anytime in... There are very few games out there that have melee and range characters where a melee class is basically on par with a range class. In general, like, it's really hard to overcome the advantages that you get by shooting anything that stays at range. You can drop down armor, you can drop down health, but you know, there's such a huge monstrous benefit to shooting off whatever it is you have at range that like I said, it's really hard to balance melee around that because they're you know, typically too strong or too weak, and I think oftentimes they end up on the too weak scale. Blizzard and this, you know, World of Warcraft, it's been no different. And Blizzard has said, you know, that they're one of their focuses on this game is to make, you know, a balance in melee versus ranged. In Diablo 2, there were a variety of mechanics, specifically Iron Maiden, that prevented most of the melee classes from doing just about anything in the higher difficulty levels. They talked about removing mechanics like that in this game. One of the first things I found out is doing our playthrough with myself and ex-Callan Krankenstein, that the playing with a witch doctor, all of his AoE mechanics, his poisons and things like that, look very similar to enemy poisons. And if you're playing as a melee class and you're trying to dance around those things on the ground, good luck, because there's no way to tell at a glance what's enemy and what's not, other than just sitting in there and watching if your health goes down. So very, very confusing, once again, as a melee component. Right now, Inferno difficulty, the game has been out a very short time, but one of the things that Blizzard doesn't seem to understand or doesn't seem to grasp is how fast people are completing content these days with the ability of, not only do you have, like, you know, teams, individuals that are, like, not only doing it for personal reasons, but oftentimes are, like, sponsored and things like that to go through and beat the game as fast as possible. And now with the advent of things like YouTube, putting out videos, more people pick up on it. It's faster and faster and faster. You put out content and it's beaten, you know, each individual patch or whatever or expansion is beaten faster than the one before it. A lot of the same mechanics that, you know, held true 10, 15 years ago are still held true today, but with the, you know, basically the interconnectedness via, you know, the internet and things like that, you know, those mechanics, those fundamentals are starting to work their way around. So, you know, not everyone is like, what's stam stacking, or how do I do this? It's that much easier to find out what's going on. Anyway, so what I was going to say is that Inferno right now is, basically what happens is you have these champion packs. The champion mobs, or elite mobs, whatever you want to call them, are much more difficult than the bosses. What they do is they spawn with a variety of variables, and as you go progress down there, or up the ladder of difficulty, they spawn with more and more variables. So, you know, maybe in normal they'll have, like, I don't know, the ability to shoot mortars at you, or the ability to put down a AoE patch of lava. Well, once you get to Inferno, they have the ability to vortex, AoE, lava, mortar, chain you, and then shield themselves. And once you run into a pack like that, what's happening is a number of things. Number one, the damage is so high right now that everybody's being one to two shot. There's really nothing you can do if you see a pack like that, especially if, you know, they're wallers and they block you in, or if they literally have the ability to just AoE. Well, there's no way to block it. They just fucking freeze you where you're at, or stun you where you're at, or something for 2 to 3 seconds, and you're dead instantly. One shot, you're gone. And it was interesting because, well, like I said, once how that relates to melee versus range, specifically because a Blizzard dev on the forum said that the Barbarian class, which has been having some difficulty advancing through Inferno, is supposed to be played via high health and Life Leech, and when you're being 1-2 shot by enemies, there is no amount of Life Leech that's going to help you out there. So, interesting that that's what they're talking about. The Blizzard dev actually did mention that maybe it's not possible to balance melee versus ranged, so we'll have to see what happens. Like I said, right now, basically, something actually XCal and I were talking about earlier today, is that because of the mechanics behind the high damage, basically behind Inferno right now, it's forcing slash encouraging people to find, I don't want to call them necessarily exploits, but people are pushing the skills and abilities as far as they can possibly go to get these really sort of warped and distorted builds that are designed around basically smashing somebody else before they can be smashed. That's all or nothing. Inferno, in my opinion right now, is basically like, it is like the epitome of an example of like why playing on a higher difficulty isn't always the most fun. It's just incredible health, incredible damage, it's kill or be killed. And what's gonna happen is, hopefully further down the line, people get more gear or something like that and start to be able to overcome it and start to be able to do what Blizzard had hoped to do, which was create a variety of builds as opposed to these fucking cookie cutter cheese ball builds that the only way to survive is to use some ridiculous, like I said, cheese build. We'll see if that happens, but you know what's going to happen is eventually, you know, you end up just smashing through the content, but until then people are just being absolutely demoralized. So we'll have to see if the gear actually does come out. I think people are complaining that it's not there. I don't know, the game's only been out a week and a half or something like that, so we'll see what happens with that. The softcore versus hardcore feel is really unique. The auction house is very, very strange, and that's part of what lends the feel to softcore and hardcore as well. Hardcore is a lot of fun because you never know what's coming around the corner, but what's so dangerous is with those new champion packs they have, they can literally just, the moment they spot you, stun you in your spot, stun you in place. That could be it for you, so that's a little scary, very, very dangerous. And because of the auction house, the way that it is, you can only sell 10 items at once, which is really odd. And then, because less than 1% of the population plays on the hardcore, the auction house has these ridiculously overpriced items and very few of them to boot. So the same character at the same level on hardcore versus softcore, my character had basically double the health and double the DPS because there were so many more options on the softcore auction house. Excuse me. I think that, like I said, I have a Barb, Demon Hunter, Wizard. I don't think I've done a Witch Doctor yet. What else? Low level Monk. But anyway, so like I said, I feel like I've played all of them, and like what people are finding is, like I said, those one hit mechanics are really demolishing those melee classes. Further down the difficulty levels, and my range classes are really smashing the balls off of everything, so feels pretty good to do that. If anybody's wondering what classes they know to play, I would recommend, you know, at this point in time, either Wizard or Demon Hunter or something like that. Haven't seen too many high level Witch Doctors. I'm sure they're doing fine too, but both Wizards and Demon Hunters have a lot of great ways right now to smash everything and avoid damage, so I go with that. They have said that they're working on, you know, trying to balance things, to fix things, but we'll see what happens. The last issue that I really want to touch on before I end this is the loot itself. The rares and blues versus legendaries. It's really strange. Basically, I mean, even like as much far as a year or two back, the devs had mentioned that the best loot in Diablo 3 is going to be like these magical or rares. And the way the loot works is there's blues, yellows, and legendaries, magical, rares, legendaries, and blue, yellow, piss brown, whatever it is. And they said that the best stats are going to come by way, most likely, of rare, which it was interesting because people were like, oh, this is an interesting idea. You know, you get, you know, I have this combination of all these random stats, and eventually you get like, you know, five stats that roll just right, blah, blah, blah. But what ends up happening is it just, the loot, the fun in that loot just does not feel like it's there. And you play D2 and you saw like a piece of loot drop, and you saw that it was unique, and you're like, oh, what could this possibly be? And You know, they were so rare, and it felt so cool to get those drops and then put that on your character and make it into this, you know, godly fucking unique beast. And right now that isn't there. The legendary items have piss poor stats. They're absurdly overpriced on the auction house, and I don't really know why, because the stats do not justify in any way, shape, or form. So I don't know if Blizzard is thinking about adding them on in the future, or adding them on in a, you know, like in a patch or an expansion. I don't know, but that loot, that joy of like finding new loot, just really isn't there. I'm getting all of my loot off the auction house, number one, and two, like I said, those, the lack of those uniques, it's just, it's so strange. It's it just doesn't feel like that excitement is there. It feels like everybody's running around in World of Warcraft decked out in like greens and blues, as opposed to like, you know, these epic drops, literally. So I don't know. It's I don't know. I'd love to hear what you guys say about it, to be honest. People have definitely have not had the kindest things to say, so we'll have to see what happens. Check the list here, see if I missed anything. I think that should about do it. I'm sure I'm running out of time. If you guys have any questions, comments, criticisms, critiques, let me know. I'm doing a lot more live streaming of this stuff, so it's a good time to interact, ask questions, tell me I'm an idiot, tell me I'm missing something, whatever. You know, keep watching those playthroughs as well, because obviously we talk a lot about bullshit in there too. So let me know what you think.